Robert Garcia Boxing Academy in Oxnard, shooting another episode of the Robert Garcia Reality Show. Check it out. Michael Finney, you look exactly like Canelo Alvarez. You ever get that?
Separated group. Do a stance. Yeah. Do a stance.
Why? No.
Hey, Michael,
don't be a faggot. Fucking do it.
Hey, Michael, so Pete, you don't know who Canelo is? You never met him?
No.
And what do you say when people tell you look like him?
I don't know. I just, sure, why not?
Why do you like boxing so much?
I don't know. Started it when I was 9 and kept doing it.
What have you won so far? What are your biggest achievements?
Junior Olympics.
How do you do with that? You took it all? You won it?
Yeah, I won.
Oh, wait, last year?
No. I turned pro last year.
Have you ever heard of Brandon Reels before? What do you think about him?
I reckon he's all right.
That's Brandon.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
This fucker is, that's good about him. He don't even know who.
Yo, you're gonna blend right in over here. You'll be fine.
I didn't know you were sparring.
You don't fucking know he's sparring.
Hey, you know he's a world.
Do you fucking know who Cameron Duncan is? Hey, do you know who Cameron Duncan is?
Yeah, I know him.
Hey, do you know Brandon's a world champion though? Did you know that?
No.
He don't know.
Did you think he was a bum when you sparred him, or do you think he was good?
I just spar. I don't care.
Does he hit hard?
Yeah.
Chester, fuck him up for me. Not my heart. I
hit.
Up,
tell him who you think he look like.
I look like Blake Griffin.
You look like Blake Griffin. We said Canelo.
That too.
You know who Blake Griffin is?
No.
So you don't watch sports at all?
No.
You motherfuckers into rodeo. Ask him a rodeo person.
Wait, okay.
I didn't say I was into it. I watch it every now and then.
Okay.
Are you into it?
Do you guys have internet in Alabama?
Yeah.
Are you on Facebook?
No.
Twitter?
No.
Do you ever look at YouTube?
No.
I got a MySpace.
No. You don't have internet at home, huh?
No.
Told you.
There's words and all the Oaxacas that come from fucking Mexico.
Wait, Mike, were you homeschooled?
Yeah.
Hey, you see, I knew that.
What?
He was homeschooled.
Why?
Wow, I like it better.
Nice. That means you're intelligent. You know who else was homeschooled? Who's that quarterback that was homeschooled?
Huh?
Tim Tebow.
Okay.
You know who he is?
Why, if you're homeschooled, you're intelligent. Why?
Why? Because you don't, you study. You don't mess around. You go to public school, you don't learn.
If you're homeschooled, you're intelligent. You go to public school, you don't learn shit. A lot of people go to college and they get masters. They don't tell me they learn shit. Daily, shut the fuck up.
I could tell who's home. That's why I knew he was homeschooled. He's a smart guy. Right?
Right.
You read a lot.
Yeah.
I bet he reads more than you read.
I don't give a fuck. I can read. I can read the numbers on my checks, so it's all good.
Why are you showing me your thumb? You sign your checks with your thumb?
I said my numbers on my checks, like holding money, bitch.
Oh.
You fucking Nelly, you...
Oh, man, I'm gonna slap this motherfucker one day.
What are you saying, Robert? How's Pelos looking in the gym? He's doing his comeback tour.
Man, Pelos is doing really good. Pelos is looking really good. He's sparring with Brandon and looking solid against Brandon. He also spars other guys, and you know, I think right now he's looking better than we started when he started about 4 or 5 years ago. I really see Pelos doing something in boxing.
See that, Ellie? I have to sit down for this fucker.
Well, he's good though. He has some pop.
He's badass, huh? What?
Why you hit him in the face once, Nestor?
I fucked up. Then he won't do this again. He'll
hit
me again.
1, 2, 3. Please show me.
So Robert, we asked people to send in questions for you and Bam Bam, and let's go through some of the questions. So question number one, Salvador Sanchez the legendary fighter who passed away at a very young age in a car accident, against Julio Cesar Chavez, who just got into the Hall of Fame. Break down that fight.
You know what, Salvador Sanchez was a tremendous champion, a tremendous warrior. I remember I was very young when my dad took me to see his fight against this Puerto Rican, I think it was Gomez. Hell of a fight. We see it in big screen. It was a hell of a fight. I think he was on his way to becoming one of the greats out of Mexico. But he died too young, so he didn't have enough time to prove what he was capable of. I think Chavez did his whole career. He had over 100 fights. So if I was to pick who would win, I think Chavez, I would say Chavez, due to the fact that he had more experience. Maybe at their same age, maybe people could pick Salvador, but throughout their career, I would say Chavez was better.
Your dad got all of you guys into boxing. How did he get into boxing?
What he tells us, he started boxing in Mexico. My dad is from Michoacan in Mexico, but he moved to Guadalajara, Jalisco to work, to help his parents and, you know, raise work, you know, for the family.
What did he do back then?
He worked, he says, in Guadalajara. He joined a church that was doing boxing fights to raise money for the church. So he would fight, just, you know, guys that would want to fight, you know, they would do fights there. So he would fight anybody to raise money for church. So that's how he got into boxing. Then when he moved to the United States at the age of 17, he moved to the Long Beach area, Long Beach, Wilmington, San Pedro. So he used to go to all the fights at the Grand Olympic, at the Great Western Forum, and that's how he got into it. You know, when we came to Oxnard, he started taking us to the gym, and that's how we became a boxing family.
Your dad, the Big G, he doesn't smile. He's always serious. Was he always like that from day one?
Like, always been like that, and always been, you know, very, very strict, very hard to, you know, hard to work with, you know, but you know, that's just the way he is, and he got good results.
Not only that, Gordo, his grandkids, your nephews are scared of him. If your grandfather gives you a look.
Big G.
The Big G. You're like, oh, Ellie, yeah. I gotta be, why?
That's how it is.
He just has to look at you and like.
That's it, just by the looks, that's it.
Show me the look on camera.
Yeah, he's right here, Robert Junior. You know that, but I'm not.
How's it look?
Gordo was, when he got that tattoo, Gordo was scared. My dad, that was the last thing he wanted.
You just got that last year.
Yeah.
And you were scared. What?
The earrings, dude.
What happened? Why?
Dude, he doesn't like that.
What was
shit.
He telling you?
He's old school, dude.
But you know what? Now he doesn't say much because he's, you know, he's already like 67, I think. So he doesn't want to get mad or anything.
But when he was younger.
But oh fuck, man, we couldn't do nothing wrong. You know, my friends were scared of doing something wrong. You know, knowing that my dad was gonna find out. They didn't even worry about
their parents.
Yeah, they worried about my dad. That
so,
is true.
What would your dad say when he saw that tattoo?
Oh man, if he, my dad, you know,
back in the days,
fuck, he would have fucking smacked him. He would have kicked his ass.
Yeah. Slapped you.
He would have maybe taken off or something.
The earrings, especially with the earrings, my dad would have never let him come into his house.
Yeah,
he would never let him come into his house with those earrings. That's just the way
strict
the way my dad is.
So another question right here. What round do you think Brandon Rios will knock out Urbano Antillon? This is a fan asking.
Oh, we can't call him. Yeah, it's gonna be a hell of a fight, a tough fight. But I do believe Brandon's gonna knock him out. But you know, Antillon is very tough, so it won't be, you know, it's not gonna be easy. So, you know, it'll be little by little breaking him down. So you know, he will knock him out. You know, if I was to pick around, I would say maybe 6 or 7.
What do you think will be the ring entrance song for Bam Bam Rios for his fight? As he's gonna enter July 9th, the Home Depot Center in Carson, thousands of fans.
You know what? It's gonna be interesting because I have a relative of mine that works for some pretty famous singers in the Mexican music business, and you know, they go around the United States doing a lot of concerts, rodeos, where they have they're doing it, they do their rodeos on horses.
He should come out on a horse, Robert. That'll be sick. That'll be like Prince Nassim Hamed.
Prince never did that.
He came in on a flying carpet.
Oh boy, that's not a horse. Travieso Arce. Travieso Arce.
So there you have it. Another episode of the Robert Garcia Reality Show. Stay tuned for more. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.